Hey guys, and welcome to my channel. So today I did a smoked liner look. No liquid liner at all and no gel liner, so it's nice and easy. It's done with just shadows and then some nice dramatic lashes as well and a pop of color in the bottom waterline. Let's see how I achieved this look. Keep on watching. Hey guys, so today I'm going to start with the Soft Ochre Paint Pot from MAC Cosmetics and their 232 brush. And just create a nice even layer all over the eye. This paint pot's awesome. It mutes the color on my eyelid if I have any purple or veins or anything like that. And if you apply too much like I just did, it's easy to blend it out with your fingers. So feel free to jump in with your fingers, unless of course you're working on a client, but makes it a lot easier. And I'm gonna go into the 35T palette from Morphe into the dusty rose color and start kind of making a wing shape. Usually I'd bring transition into the crease, but we don't want to do that today. We want to kind of drag it out, trying to elongate the eyes. Blah, blah, blah. And I'm also using the Morphe M514 brush, and this look is a lot of blending, so prepare to see a lot. Going in with the E17, I'm going to pack on this deep purple color and still keeping it nice and close to the lash line. You don't want to drag it up, so you still want to see the transition above, and we're going to pull it out in that wing shape still. Going in with this tan color from the 35T palette, I'm going to start to blend it out. I did wipe my brush off, of course, but I'm going to jump in with my trusty M441 brush and just blend it out. Makes it a little bit easier. And the tan color you can bring a little bit into the crease, but keeping those purple tones lower and at that wing shape. And the good thing about not doing your face first, like I usually do, I can use a makeup wipe. These are the Kirkland makeup wipes to tidy up the wing and sharpen it. Going in with the S4, it's basically a concealer brush, but I'm gonna actually jump into the Huda Beauty palette because the 35T doesn't have a cream color. So I'm just going to brighten my inner eye with the color Bay, and as well as brighten my brow bone. This is a small angle brush from the Morphe Vegan set, and I'm going to go back into the Huda Beauty palette into Black Truffle. And I'm going to start very low, so start thin, and I'm going to make a small wing. The good thing about doing a wing with shadow, you don't have to worry about it being smooth or straight. It can be kind of fuzzy because it makes it just look actually more smoky, which is perfect. And then you're going to, without adding any more product, you're going to start to brush upwards. This is going to smoke it out and kind of make that transition into those deep purple and the soft dusty color. And bringing it down into the inner eye as well. A trick for the inner eye is flipping your brush, actually how mine is right now, and having the point of the brush face your inner eye and pulling outwards rather than downwards and the brush flipped. And then going in with this small shader brush, this is the M213. And kind of padding color, so I did add a little bit of Black Truffle onto the brush, not a lot, just to kind of make it a little bit smoother, and brushing upwards as well. And this is actually a lip brush from the Morphe Vegan set, but I'm going to just put a little bit of this MAC pigment in vanilla at the inner eye to continue to brighten it, because doing a smoky look, I have small eyes, so I like to open my eyes as much as possible. And these are the Iris Beauty lashes in Cleopatra. Normally you should add mascara once your lashes are on to fuse your natural lashes with the false lashes, but because these lashes are so expensive to get in Canada, I like to do this first to try and keep them as clean as possible for as long as possible. So then I'm going to just attach the center, attaching the outside and then the inside. Doing it this way can help to stabilize the outer part of the lash so that you can really focus on getting it right on the lash line, not the inner eye. And same thing on the other side. And going in with the Make It Forever 172 brush, I'm just going to pack Black Truffle onto the lash glue because it is shiny. It's dark tone, but it's still shiny. So I'm just going to matte it out so it's nice and smooth still. And then going in with the Urban Decay 24/7 Glide On Pencil in Provision. I'm going to tight line this little area. And then going in with another 24/7 Glide On Pencil by Urban Decay in Mildew, I'm going to tight line the bottom, as well as kind of pull it into my bottom lash line. The reason I'm doing this is because I know I'm going to smoke out the bottom anyway, so I do want it to be nice and smooth and not see my skin tone through my bottom lashes at all. And then going in with this small pencil brush from Morphe, this is the M149. I'm going to take that deep purple from the 35T palette, and smoke out the bottom lash line. This brush I'm using right now is the Morphe M514. It's a smaller version of that large blending brush I was using earlier, and it's amazing for blending out the bottom lash line. This is a small shader brush I was using earlier, and I'm just going to add Black Truffle and continue to smoke it out and kind of join that wing, even though it's not a solid line, into the bottom lash line. This is the Tatcha Luminous Skin Mix to hydrate, as well as the Smashbox Primer Oil, which is my favorite right now. I also put it on my lips to hydrate my lips. And then because I do have texture on my skin in my T-zone in the center of my face, I'm going to use the Make It Forever Smoothing Primer. And I'm going totally overboard and using MAC Strobe Cream with a Make It Forever flat foundation brush and highlighting under my eyes, my cheekbones, and my forehead. This is the Anastasia Concealer. I used to use this all the time. I got it when it first came out, and I didn't like it, so I thought I'd try it again, but it cakes on powder once you add powder to it, so it's definitely not my favorite. It worked for this look for now, but, and that was the Morphe Beauty, or Flawless Beauty Sponge, sorry. And I'm going to use the Make It Forever Stick Foundation, my favorite stick foundation, and the Morphe M439 to blend this out. Going in with the Laura Mercier translucent powder to bake. I'm using a dry beauty blender because I used a damp one and it caked it on too much, but I think I just have to use it a little bit drier, but it has to have some form of moisture to it because the powder doesn't stick to my face. So, and I'm going to throw my brows on because I am going to do a video on different types of brows you can do soon, so stay tuned for that. And this is the MAC Mineralized Skin Finish with the G0 brush from Morphe, and I'm just gonna set my entire face. And because my Laura Mercier powder did go up onto my lash line, just kinda touch it up a little bit. I use the Fusion Beauty Mascara for my bottom lashes. I'm having an issue with my bottom lashes right now. Some are weirdly long, I have an actual patch that's just missing. I think I might have pulled it out, but I'm gonna take some mascara off because I do want my bottom lashes to be black, but I don't want them to be accentuated really because they're so funny looking. You can if you want, but I don't want them to be spidery for this look. I'm just adding a tiny layer or a thin layer. Now I'm going in with the Anastasia Contour Kit in medium to tan. I have the medium to tan because I was gonna do freelance way back when I first finished school, but I ended up getting my job, so that's why I have that one. And adding a little bit of the primer oil to my lips to hydrate, and going into the 9B palette by Morphe with a large angle brush from the Morphe Vegan set. And this is the That Glow Kit from Anastasia Beverly Hills with the A23 brush by them, just to highlight my cheekbones, the end of my nose, as well as my Cupid's bow. And this is my favorite MAC Cosmetics pencil right now. This is the half red pencil. I'm just going to line my lips. I do overdraw a little bit, especially in the Cupid's bow, because mine is so pointy. I like to soften it a little bit. And then this is the studded lipstick by Kat Von D. Studded Kiss Lipstick in Wolf's Mouth. And it's a little bit metallic, so I really like it actually. This is the Urban Decay Chill Makeup Setting Spray, just to set my entire face. Okay, thanks so much for watching, guys. I will be uploading Tuesdays and Fridays, and I hope you enjoyed this. Please comment below, subscribe, and like, and let me know what you thought. Thanks.